Welcome back. So, this is literally, it could be my second last video, but this is probably my last video in the truck, and I'm super stoked. It's so hot down here in Florida, it's a good thing. I love Florida. But, this is my second last day. I'm going to make my way down to Miami. I got about 100 miles to go or so. Oh man, I'm super stoked to get out of this truck. Alright, so there's something I want to talk about today, and that is regarding relationships on, specifically, children and adults. This isn't specifically parenting, but it's just on the aspect of children and adults. So I have a buddy up in New York, and he told me that, a weird story, but it's not very weird nowadays that it is weird, but if that makes sense. But yeah, like he was telling me that he was hanging out with his daughter's sister, young girl, I don't know what age, I'm gonna guess either a toddler or a little bit older, and hanging out with her. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that they're on the beach or somewhere out in public, maybe in a park or something. And he's with his daughter's sister, which is his daughter's mom's older daughter. Whatever, right? You get it. It's not his daughter, but it's his daughter's sister. Alright, so he's hanging out with her and playing with her and such and having a good time. And it's starting to get warm up in New York. And he had his shirt off. You know, just soaking in the rays, running around with his daughter's sister. And to other people, they thought it was extremely weird that this grown man is playing with this little girl. Extremely weird. And to make it even weirder for them, he had his shirt off because it's starting to get warm out. Now, this isn't a guy that's fat and just like nobody should be seeing him, right? He's relatively in shape for his age. And just hanging out with his daughter's youngest sister. And everyone found it fucking weird, according to the story that I heard. But it shouldn't be weird, right? This is like family, and it's an adult hanging out with his daughter's sister. And it shouldn't be weird, in my eyes. It should be normal. You know, what are you supposed to be doing? Just like, you stay over there, I won't talk to you. Like, what are you supposed to be doing? No, the kid's having a blast, smiling, enjoying life. And my buddy was enjoying life because he gets to hang out with his daughter's little sister. So they both had a pleasurable, enjoyable experience, right? But there's a third party aspect of people who see this and go, that's fucking weird. What are you, some pedophile? What are you doing? And nothing pisses me off more than everybody thinking that a grown man hanging out with a child has to be a pedophile if it's not their own kid. Fucking drives me insane. You know, I have a little cousin who's like 20 years younger than me, like 10 years old. And if I was to, for whatever reason, hang out with him in public, people might think that's weird. Because I'm 30 and he's 10 and it's not my child. But that's my cousin, right? I mean, I don't understand. I mean, I do understand what people are getting at. It's that people are scared of everything that they see on the news. They see one out of every million people are, I'm probably exaggerating, probably one out of every 100,000 people are pedophiles. So that ruins it for the other 100 fucking thousand people, right? Not to mention the children. So, this is becoming a form of abandonment, right? So, when I was a child, I was still in the age where adults can hang out with kids, right? I was still in probably the last days of that. Before everybody keeps your kid inside and can't have them outside and talking to strangers and stuff. I was the kid that was hanging out with everybody. You know, my typical day, like in the summertime, not non-school related days, would be going outside as soon as the sun rose and coming back every few hours to eat. That was my typical day. And I don't mean I was a teenager at the time. I mean I was like 7, 8. Until I was, you know, in teenage days. Then I decided not to be playing outside because everybody started getting weird and everyone stayed inside. And it wasn't the same anymore when I got older. But the point is that I'm trying to get at is that I remember hanging out with adults. Didn't think anything of it. You know, I would be smart enough and aware enough to notice if something was weird. Like, if the guy's offering me candy to get in his car and he was a complete stranger. That's weird. You learn better. You get taught by your parents that that is wrong. And that that's going to be setting you up for something that's not good to happen, right? But at the same time, if it's family and you're out in public, people are weirded out now. What is going on? As a guy at the age of 30, and I have no children, I'm gonna start seeming to the average dumbass that I shouldn't be around their children because it's a grown man. Now, girls, they don't really get the same problem as men when it comes to children. If I was a guy and go, oh, the kid's so cute, and to a random person, people are going to be like, get the fuck away from my kid. But I'm being relatively nice, and I'm like, it's like if you had a dog, right, and your dog looks so awesome, I just want to, you know, pet your dog. Well, at the same way, I feel the same way about your children. Your children are fucking cute, adorable, and maybe I want to interact. Not allowed in 2017. And I've definitely made it a thing where I don't talk to children because of this shit. And it's putting a distance on the understanding of children and adults. It's actually not healthy. Now, if I have guy friends and I have children, my guy friends are hanging out with my fucking children. They're not going to be feeling like, you know, it's a weird situation. I'll make sure that it's a decent situation and that everyone's involved. Personally, I think that's great for the development of children to be around adults. Any adult. It doesn't have to be a stranger as long as it's parent approved, right? I don't care what other people think about who's hanging out with my children. You know, straight up. I don't care. And you shouldn't as well. But at the same time, I can't go out and just, you know, I don't even do it with dogs anymore because now it's weird, right? It's weird to be talked to, like, out in public. Like, it's just weird now. Everybody's stuck in their peer groups or their family unit. And anything outside of that is deemed weird. And I've noticed it because now I'm getting the vibration and the frequencies that I would be the weird one. Like, that's why I just avoid it altogether. How weird is that? You're teaching your children that everybody is a pedophile, everybody's a killer, everybody's a rapist, everybody is probably in that category. So when a child is brought up into a world where everybody is out to get them, and they're a valuable resource in the eyes of evil, you know, how are they going to grow up and live? It's not teaching them good examples of who people are and what you should be as a person. And I believe if they establish good rapport or relationship with adults, I believe straight up that it's better for them to understand that there are decent people out there and adults and such. And they can strive to be motivated to, or better yet, a good role model as an adult. I think that's what children need. They need good role models as adults because what they're seeing on television are totally the worst role models possible, right? The worst role models are publicized on television. So that's what they get. And they don't get it in real life because, well, they're not allowed to talk to to adults, especially men. They're not allowed to talk to men. But I hear stories like this all the time. So Bill Burr, he's one of my favorite comedians. And he was making a whole bit about it, about being an adult, can't talk to children, get it away from me, I don't want it around me. And I feel the same way. Like, if you have children, get it away from me, right? Because everybody else around is going to think something weird is going on, when there completely is nothing evil or weird really going on. You're making it like that as a third party. There should be children playing with adults. In fact, there should be no age barrier on this. I'm somebody who believes age is just fucking retarded to think that this number prevents you from hanging out with them. You know? I really think that's ridiculous that age is a factor. Now, there's times where if I had children that I wouldn't have them definitely hang around with some people I know. Right? Like, get out of there. I don't want my children to even know you exist. Right? But it has nothing to do with age. I don't care if they're a 13-year-old smoking pot. I probably don't want them around my children. You know, if my child's 13 and that kid's 13 smoking pot, same thing if I have an adult buddy who's just doing something like snorting coke or something, I don't want him around my children. This has nothing to do with age. Age has no aspect to what my children should be exposed to. Age has no difference. So I'm at the age now that it's weird to be hanging out with children if that's not my children. And I really want to flip the script on this. So, as parents, teach your fucking children that, yes, there are some bad fuckers out there, and that they should never accept candy or gifts from strangers or whatever, right? Teach them the right things. But at the same time, don't seclude them from hanging out with decent people just because of their age. That's just ridiculous to me. It is. It really is ridiculous to me that we're living in a world now that if you're at a birthday party from your friend's child's just turned 8, you know, you gotta be playing the role of, hey, how you doing, little buddy, or whatever, and then pretend they don't exist and try to run away and hide from them. That's ridiculous. Once upon a time, there was adults showing up to kids' parties. Today, not as much. Why? Because of this problem. And the problem isn't the pedophilia. Is that a problem? Obviously. But that's not the problem I'm talking about. The problem I'm talking about is the third party judging and keeping their kids away from decent adults. Because 1 in 100,000 of them might be thinking something weird. And then, like, out of the pedophiles, it's like 1 out of every 200,000 that actually do something, right? I'm just throwing numbers out my ass. But the point is that every fucking adult isn't a fucking weirdo. Straight up. Okay. Okay, most adults are weirdos, but not in the aspect I'm trying to tell you. In fact, children are weirdos too. And that's a good thing. Being weird is a good thing. I know I'm going to lose subscribers from this. Not that it matters, because I lose subscribers every video. I get 2 subscribers, 2 leave. I get 2 more subscribers, 2 leave. So, I'm quite used to it. It doesn't even bother me. I don't even care if I stay at 80 subs the rest of my life. As long as some people get some value out of this, that's all that really matters. And to say that I tried, and I actually put some great information on YouTube. So, the fact is, if you're a third party person, looking in on a situation and have to put in your 2 cents no matter what the situation is, there's something wrong with you. You don't know that scenario. Other people don't live their lives exactly how you live your lives. And some people don't have the exact same beliefs that you do. In some cultures, they never even think of this weird paradigm until they move to America. Then they're like, why the fuck does this exist? Well, it's because of you. So you put out a vibration into the universe that the universe has to respond to. So if you think that everybody's out to get you, everybody's out to get your kids, all this vibration, you are actually instilling the vibration that is going to bring forth that which you fear the most. I suggest not putting out this vibration. Put out a good vibration. Good feelings attract good feelings, which attract good feelings, which become great feelings for everyone. If you have this weird mentality that there's going to be someone going to abduct your kids and you got to protect them at all costs, at all moments of time, you live in the most peaceful time in history. The most peaceful time in history. And now's the time that you're scared to have your children walk out that door and do what they want to do? You live in the most peaceful time in history. And now it's a problem, right? Because less people than ever are these weirdos. But they're being exposed more than ever. You know, you find a fucking weirdo 30 miles away and they go get on the news. You think everybody's like that. It's just fucking ridiculous. Adults should be hanging out with kids. Kids should be hanging out with adults. Kids should be hanging out with kids. Kids should be hanging out with fucking elderly people. It doesn't fucking matter. This weirdness that's breaking up all this stuff and making men scared to even look at a child is fucking weird, and it's destroying our culture. Straight up. Destroying our culture. It's destroying the fabric of who we are. Alright, speed up, guy. Speed up. Speed up. You're empty, dude. Speed up. Dude, if you don't fucking speed up, I'm gonna fucking get heated. There you go, champ. I don't know what it is about truck drivers. When they get onto the expressway from the ramp, half of them don't even fucking... They're like in La La Land. I swear, they're in fucking La La Land. Me personally, I'm going back to what I was talking about. Me personally, I wish that we lived in a world of love, not fear. And the problem is fear is destroying who we are and what we're capable of. And the potential that each of us have is ruptured by fear. However, with love and, you know, all around just oneness and love, this is the characteristic and the quality and the frequency that you want to have around you at all times. For your children, for you, for your loved ones, whoever, right? And that's a very good paradigm because, well, what have I been talking about karma lately? That good frequency is bringing good things happening to you. No one has the greatest time ever and then just gets disrupted. Because the reason why that you get disrupted is because of bad frequency and bad vibes. That's how you get disrupted. How did I talk about going to Mexico, right? Going to Mexico, you have bad frequency, bad vibes, and then you go down a dark alley in the middle of Mexico City, or you name it. Dark alley, you're clearly vulnerable, you already look like you're, you know, out of place, and then you add the aspect of negative frequencies and fear and stuff like that. Well, what's going to happen? Well, the universe has to respond to you. And people will do that in which you fear. If you're bringing out fear, the thing that you fear the most is going to affect you. So, look at it that way. Because, well, what happens? Look at even fear factor. If you're scared of spiders, and you know that you're going into a realm of spiders, let's say, I think there's Fear Factor coming out again, so that's the only reason I brought it up. I saw it on an ad on YouTube. But anyways, so if you're afraid of spiders and then you got to get into a cage with a bunch of spiders, you're going to be freaking out like crazy, and you're going to have the worst experience ever. But if you're not bringing out that fear, so let's say you're unaware of what's going to happen to you, it's not going to be as bad. Now, if you're going into something beautiful and good, you're going in with great vibrations and stuff, like how women look at men. They fall in love pretty much instantly, as opposed to working its way up to love, right? They like what they see, they like what they hear, and then they have all these, you know, for example, if they hear that a guy is good in bed, and they're about to go out with the same guy that's great in bed, and this other girl loved it, right? Love being with this guy, and now it's your turn to be with this guy, and you hear about how great he is and stuff, and then you go to hang out with him that night, you're going to have all the fucking, great, happy fucking feelings, right? And you're going to really, really like this guy, but you're putting out this frequency that you really, really like this guy, and blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. So what's going to happen when you go to that date? It's going to be overwhelmingly great, because you've put it in your mind that it's going to be this great, and then you actively, the universe has to respond to that great feeling that you have. So your great feeling, your vibration is going to get to the guy, which is going to raise him up to that same vibration, and it's just going to be an overall great experience. If you are in a negative mood going out on a date, well, what's going to happen? You're going to ruin the experience. So understand what I'm trying to get at. This also works with all types of relationships. Adults, children, third-party people trying to get involved. If you're constantly have this, oh my God, he shouldn't be hanging out with this child. Well, what's going to happen? First off, no pedophile is going out to the park in the middle of all these fucking weirdos that think every guy's a pedophile and protect our children. No guy's going to the park and picking up a kid in front of everybody, right? This person's trying to do it where people probably don't see them. So if you're seeing this guy hanging out with a child, pretty much rest assured that this guy's not up to nothing weird. Nothing like that. So, I don't know. It's a really weird video, but I'm glad I got it out of the way. My channel is about happiness and longevity, and I think that the third party person that prejudges, that's what's ruining things. If an adult like me, trust me, I want to hang out with kids. Why not? They still have hopes and dreams. You know, it's when you become an adult where you fucking just robotic and robust and, well, not robust, but stupid. And children still have that spark and that flame, and I like that. But I can't hang out with fucking children because of you fuckers. Anyways, with all that out of the way, it's OPEX, happiness, longevity, peace, anarchy, I'm out.